What is going on, beautiful people? Welcome back to another amazing and impactful episode of the True Health Forever podcast, where we tell our best life through lens of holistic health. I'm your host, right? I feel like when we take our time with it, we hit it. We lock eyes, you know what I'm saying? It's crispy. Yeah. I'm your host, Devon Truvel, creator of Black Wall Street, the board game, and currently with a broken jaw. And as usual, I have with me, I'll give you some context later. It hurts. As usual, I have with me the beautiful, the smiling, the curl-rific need for speed queen herself. Don't you? Oh, you go track like you don't be speeding? That's what we're going to do today on the podcast? You going to start off like that?
I don't know what you're talking about. What's up, party people? My name is Sinclair, a.k.a.
The Health Nerd.
And apparently, I do. I am a safe speeder. Meaning, I do speed, but I don't go, you know, crazy above the speed limit. But I do it in a safe way, right?
Cool. Let's do it. What'd you put in this chia pudding?
It's fire, right? Oh,
it's,
or not.
It's cool. It has an interesting.
That because it was really good.
It's chocolatey.
Yeah, it's the new Organifi Harmony.
Organifi. I'm gonna need y'all to talk to me before you make any type of flavor decisions. Okay, that one. Anyway, Queen, you ready to get into it?
Yeah.
Hey, it's all good. You doctored it up. But anyway, without further ado, let's get into the episode. Yeah, we're going to talk through a little bit. I do have the book that we're going to go through, not go through in details, but Growth Mindset by Dr. Carol. How do you say this last name? Dweck? Or is it just Weck?
Dweck.
Listen, Dweck. Carol D. Carol D. So a quote right here, and then we'll shift over to talk about the Queen's example. But grow your mindset. Think about your hero. Do you think of this person as someone with extraordinary abilities who achieves with little effort? Right? I've always, like, think about that. I feel like when we think about heroes, and who's your favorite Avengers hero?
I feel like you've asked me this. I don't know if I have one. I have multiple, but I do like Tony Stark.
Why?
Because he's, and I see where you're going here. He is human.
Which means?
He's relatable.
Mm-hmm.
I'm like, oh, I could do that.
Right.
If I had the ability to create a whole Iron Man suit. But yeah, I feel like it makes it more relatable. Everybody else has like superhuman capabilities. So it's like, I can't really relate to that. I'm not an alien. I'm human.
Right. And I think taking that step further, because my favorite is also Tony Stark / Black Panther. Mm-hmm. But Tony Stark has a level of vulnerability because he's human in a world of superheroes. Two, you see him bleed. You see his literal effort when he's being a superhero. Thor's over here flying, throwing hammers, bringing down lightning. And Tony Stark, yes, he has all his technology, but at the end of the day, like, his stuff gets damaged. Sometimes the face mask comes off. When he was battling Thanos, you see literally blood coming through. So it's like you see the effort. And I feel like in that kind of battle and seeing someone's like true emotions and putting 120-150%, they become your favorite. You start to put them up on a pedestal because you're like, dang, I wish I can try like that.
Deep. Not I wish I could do that, but I wish I could try, I wish I could triumph like that.
Right, because at the end of the day, Tony Stark, I mean, rest in peace, even though it's a fake, even though it's a fake world. that's how real Avengers gets. It's like RIP, Tony Stark, he's no longer here. But yeah, the fact that he died, I mean, yes, he was successful in a way, but he also died. So like, yeah, at the end of the day, it's like, dang, are you willing to try that much, 200-2000% to put it on the line to possibly fail?
But even if you think about the movie, right, in the movie he even is so vulnerable to the point where like he's battling his own selfishness. right? Because he didn't even want to do it. He's like, I got my family. I got my kid. I got my, like, I'm good. I realize everybody else lost something, but I'm good. And you're asking me to give this up for the greater good. And it's, he battles with that. And I feel like we all as humans felt that too. And it's like, oof. But he ended up doing it anyways. And I feel like that's that triumph again. And then pays his ultimate sacrifice. So I feel like he does, he's almost painted as the ultimate hero in that way. Fair. Not because he didn't struggle, but because you see all of his very human struggles and he does it anyways.
Good bar. Good bar. Woo! All right, we can...